位，歡迎收睇《廿六分鐘見證實錄》。喺疫情影響之下，各類型嘅活動無奈唔可以繼續面對面舉行，對整個活動策劃行業帶嚟明顯嘅衝擊。不過喺疫情嘅推進之下，唔少活動轉為網上舉辦，以新穎嘅模式繼續同參加者互動，務求唔需要真人接觸都可以做到同人保持聯繫。在今集的节目，我们就会带大家了解网上策展的兴起，以及筹备网上活动背后所需要的准备工作。疫情期间，实体活动因为卫生指引无法进行，一度令本地活动陷入停顿。
初头三四月，即去年三四月的时候，大家都有些震惊，都要想一下，停一停，想一下到底这个方向是什么。
A lot of the charities had to consider whether or not to move forward.To cancel their event for the year, or to look to others and to see what else was happening.
在非常時期，一些實體活動因應疫情限制轉為網上舉辦，塑造活動策劃新形態。
我哋都不停諗下有咩新意思啦。咁因為可能疫情既然都唔係咁快走啦，咁我哋都會做一啲所謂我哋行內叫 hybrid 嘅 event 啦。咁即係話本有現場嘅播映啦，有啲可能係錄影啦，但有一啲就係互動嘅。
實體活動轉型至網上舉辦會面對乜嘢挑戰？咁透過熒幕又可以點樣保持人同人之間嘅聯繫呢
？Cause we were live streaming the concert for that.1.5 hours, and I was very worried. I was like, what happens if halfway through the concert, some sort of connection issue, we get lost, and then the people can't see what's happening.
可以問個大廚有啲問題啦，或者大廚就睇下，哎，你煮成點啊？有冇問題啊？咁樣，咁所以一個交流咯，依個就我哋覺得係最特別嘅地方。
Wish everyone the Ox Year, Happy New Year, and good health. 恭喜發財 Bye.
Bye.
Bye. 恭喜發財
呢一個慶祝農曆新年嘅網上烹飪活動，一切係點樣開始嘅呢？
做蘿蔔糕同跟我哋會加啲淮山就比較健康，咁其實有臘腸啊、冬菇啊，所有嘢我哋都提供咗嘅。
Helen 余振敏係本地一間公關公司嘅負責人。呢一日佢同同事 Vivian 喺列治文一個商場擺放攤位，俾兩日之後參加網上親子烹飪活動嘅參加者預先領取所需要嘅食材。
農曆新年啦，咁啊，因為好多家庭而家未必可以一齊享受呢個年夜飯啦，或者其他慶祝，咁所以我哋諗到就係喺網上做呢個活動，咁大家都可以透過呢啲平台啦，咁就可以學一個大廚教嘅兩個菜式。
今次是 Helen 第一次舉辦網上直播的烹飪活動，她希望在疫情期間增加人和人之間的互動，透過網上烹飪活動一同慶祝農曆新年，並為列治文一個慈善組織籌款。
為什麼這個活動特別呢？就是有得互動咯。咁如果唔係大家上網睇 YouTube 度學都一樣啦，咁但係今次唔同就係、是透過個 Zoom 嘅個平台咧，我哋就可以互動。
今次嘅活動一共有12組參加者，其中列治文市長夫人 Christine Brody 同家人都有參與。今次係佢第一次參與網上烹飪活動。
It's interesting because I've been doing a lot of teaching online, and so I have that experience, and I think you could actually.Connect with emotions over Zoom. So I'm looking forward to being as excited and especially to have my grandkids and my daughter on the other side of the screen. So that will be a lot of fun and to be able to have this as an experience that we shared during 2021. And it's especially nice because it's a family event and being able to do things as a family is so important to everybody.
Okay, okay. Yeah, it's okay. Before, I was very professional. I was very big. Now, a lot of times, it's portable. It's real. It's real. It's real. It's real. It's real. It's real.交貨咁就係，你再遲啲咁多，而家喺個需求裏邊就已經太遲啦。你見到我哋咧，隨時拿住個手機啊，亦都係可以拍唔同嘅訪問啊、採訪啊、節目啊。
差唔多啦嘛，得，等等我洗埋個鍋先。
我有少少擔心㗎，其實臨嚟之前，因為第一次做啊嘛。咁
Karen呢樣係邊個照？我都係温暖，
應該係温暖，即係嗰啲。
咁今日其實都有同事喺網上做其他嘢咯，咁嚟唔到，咁但係我哋都即係可以，因為合作慣咗咧，咁就容易啲咯。
呢、這個你我咁樣坐，我聽唔到你講嘢。如果你係譬如你同側啲人講嘢，你如果我裝我聽到咧，你佢又咪？如果你想講，我哋全部聽到。試試。
我哋出三二一。Hello everybody, welcome to the first ever charity virtual charity cooking Chinese New Year style with Chef
Hello.
Hi
everyone, how are you?
呢一日係 Helen 第一次舉辦網上親子烹飪活動嘅日子。當日請嚟大廚韋少涵 Dennis 教授參加者製作淮山蘿蔔糕同淮山杞子餃子兩道健康賀年食品。
Make sure you seal it tight。
嗰陣時 Helen 同我傾嗰陣時，佢就話第一樣嘢就係新年啦。咁新年就我係即係一定要教年糕噶啦。咁同埋點解今日會揀餃子呢？就係、是、Helen 都同我講過，佢有啲即係朋友，佢屋企係傳統過節啊，即係尤其是過新年咧，就係、是、做依個餃子嘅。咁我就諗住啊，不如做一個兩款都係健康啲，同埋有樣嘢我今日咧就原用咗一個材料係放兩個餸，就係、是、依個淮山。嚇點解呢？就係、是、第一淮山健康啦，咁同埋而家係一個趨勢，我哋食好多譬如過時過節啊，任何菜式都健康，咁同埋係唔好有廚餘咯。
And then we can start steaming the CNY cake。
活動以網上會議平台 Zoom 舉辦，另外亦都同步喺 YouTube 上直播。咁對於 Dennis、Helen 同製作團隊嚟講，都係新嘗試。
Live 咧同 Zoom 咧有兩種咧，都係形式去對住觀眾嘅嚇。咁啊 ，Zoom 有度好處咧，就係有可以互動，直接就係即係個主持人可以同對方嗰邊對話啊，有啲咩問題馬上可以直接問，甚至乎可以同你哋對話。喺 YouTube 上咧都係可以直播嘅。個問題咧就係只有你 perform 俾人睇，而佢嗰邊係冇得發問啊之類。Show 咧。我接到都好開心，因為真係好新嘅挑戰啊！因為同步一齊 ，OK， 同步我哋做得多，就係話現場嘅，或者個麥交翻俾邊個地方，依個麥交咧，依啲可以做到。有問題 ，Zoom 同 YouTube 做法咧，呢個屬於係首創。
Yes, raise your hand, please。
做 visual 嘅 cooking class 咧，都係第一次。咁啊，同埋可以喺個鏡頭面前可以望到咁多同學仔咧，嗰、那個 reaction 咧係好得意嘅咯。因為平時我教班係即係 face to face 啊，或者係即係電視啊，或者即係喺我自己 online 嗰度啦。咁你睇唔到對方嗰、那個那個反應噶嘛？咁但係今日咧就可以睇到曬咯。咁同埋亦都學識咗哦，原來做 facial 嘅話咧，有啲嘢咧，因為大家開曬麥啊嘛。即係對方又聽到你講乜，你人哋又聽到你講乜咁樣，咁即係可能有時交流啊，嗰陣時可能要等人哋講完之後，我先至再講。今日學咗好多嘢，但係好開心咯。
疫情期間 ，Helen 同團隊亦都舉辦過其他網上活動，當中加入互動元素，令網上活動變得更加生動。
and I wrote the total on the back.
嗰一次就會請咗一個magician， 咁就佢喺 Seattle 就 zoom in， 然之後俾表演俾我哋睇。咁大家都覺得哇反應好好，因為真係好有現場感。咁佢亦都好同我哋嘅參加者互動啦，就叫佢譬如估下 pair 牌啊，估下嗰啱錢裏面有幾多咁。但係真係大家都好驚奇，竟然即係做到咁現場嘅反應咯。
而佢策劃嘅加拿大國慶打鼓活動，舊年更加吸引更多城市參與，得到嘅反應都唔錯。
嗰個節目可能真係慳咗啲場地，因為要搭個台喺一個公眾嘅地方啊，做音響其實係好貴嘅。咁今次就反而喺 Zoom 上邊都會可以慳到一啲開支啦。咁亦都可以 reach 到一啲平時我哋 reach 唔到嘅人。咁因為其他城市咧一般都有自己的慶祝活動啦，咁而家大家都轉為網上，咁我哋反而可以contact 到一啲城市，譬如 Markham 喺 Ontario 啊、Richmond Hill 嗰啲，佢哋都會參加我哋嘅活動，咁就反而用咗我哋活動成為佢哋個慶祝嘅互動嘅部分。因為大家都知道做一個互動嘅節目唔係咁簡單咯，咁佢哋大家行內人都覺得哇！其實你哋做咗呢個平台，咁佢哋加入去反而係對佢哋嚟講個節目仲豐富咗。
雖然網上活動節省部分嘅場地費用，但係喺疫情期間要揾到合適嘅地方拍攝，亦都唔太容易。
我諗又係關於疫情啦，因為都唔可以咁容易揾到一啲場地可以俾我哋啲crew嚟用。咁我哋最後就諗咗一個發展商啦，就會借到一個可以用得嘅廚房，因為好多時嗰啲示範單位嘅廚房係唔可以用噶嘛。咁今次係有爐頭啦，又可以真係蒸嘢啊成。咁所以我哋就好多謝佢哋可以俾到我哋用呢個廚房啦。
我哋覺得呢個係一個好有意義嘅活動啦。第一，咁就係因為而家 Covid 嘅關係啦，大家都希望係有多啲嘅聯繫啦，但係就實際上又唔可以親自見到面喎。咁呢一種嘅網上嘅互動咧，係相當之有意義嘅，係相當之好去聯繫多啲人嘅關係啦。亦都另外一樣嘢咧，呢、這個嘅贊助咧，亦都係為咗公益啦。Aspect Developments 咧，亦都係最重要係最支持好多嘅公益活動嘅。我哋覺得呢個公益活動好有意義啦。
雖然疫情期間無法舉行式嘅熱鬧嘅聚會同活動，但係網上拆展無阻人同人之間嘅聯繫，亦都激發一啲慈善組織帶嚟新嘅活動模式。下一節翻嚟我哋再睇。在疫情新常態之下，活動研討會網上化已經是無可避免的趨勢。過往依靠大型宴會籌款的慈善組織，在疫情之下如何利用網上策展的新模式繼續做公益活動呢？
We just go around the Zoom room and let each team introduce yourselves.Why are you here today?
我哋都不停諗下有咩新意思啦。咁因為可能疫情既然都唔係咁快走啦，咁我哋都會做一啲所謂我哋行內叫 hybrid 嘅 event 啦。咁即係話有現場嘅播映啦，有啲可能係錄影啦，但有一啲就係互動嘅。
疫情下，活動策劃行業同製作團隊需要合作，打造合適嘅網上活動，因應需要選擇播放平台。
而家好多 virtual show 啦，有啲係現場咧就揾到主持人啦，咁咧就其他嗰啲節目都係收集翻嚟嘅。咁收集咗之後咧，就選咗個節目咧，就可以咧就係我哋做收集編排，然後贊助商廣告。
過往好多慈善團體透過大型晚會籌款，疫情下一啲公益活動漸漸轉為網上舉辦。
Welcome everyone to our very first virtual crystal ball. My name is Fred Lee and I am so excited to be with you here tonight.
I would say now I've done about a dozen or so galas, maybe a little more. And with each one, they've gotten better and better.
經常在各大活動出現的 Fred Lee, 疫情之前一个星期至少出席七个活动，除了担任嘉宾，亦都经常主持现场拍卖环节。他留意到疫情初期很多慈善组织都不知道怎样决定活动去向，无奈要取消活动或者延迟举办日期。
Last update I gave, there was over 125 that were postponed and some were eventually cancelled. Obviously, when we get into May and June, I think there was a lot of graduations that were occurring online, whether they were high school graduation or university graduation. And that was one of the very, I think first times that a lot of people saw how institutions pivoted.
在去年5月左右，一些组织打破惯例，尝试以网上形式举办各类活动。
For many of these organizations, going into an area that they had never gone or stepped foot in before. So certainly they've had some experience working with suppliers on the creation of videos, the building of their sets, their stages and all of that. But then now to really pivot and put an event on virtually, it was a new territories.
Originally in May, we usually have a in-person, like a Mother's Day high tea event, but because of COVID, it got canceled. And then, so we had to rethink, kind of, we still wanted to do some sort of fundraising event, so we had to turn towards a more virtual kind of method to raise funds. It was our first time doing a virtual concert. It's our first time live streaming a concert. And then it was the first time live streaming for our producer as well. Our producer does like videography and everything, but she has never really done YouTube live before. So I think that was the moment, like when the concert went live that evening, the whole team was, I don't know if the whole team was nervous, but for me, myself, I was very nervous because I was like, as you mentioned, I was like,Is the connection gonna cut off?
慈善组织 D2D 基金会去年八月第一次举办网上慈善音乐会，收集世界各地年轻歌手的表演制作成音乐会，最终为 BC 儿童医院筹得超过116,000元。
The way we assembled the concert was we got the performers beforehand, and then but then that event we had two MCs, so I think it kind of made it more smooth.And then in between each performer, we had patient stories because I think it's very important for the audience to understand what kind of cause or where the money goes towards. So the patient stories really inspire the donors and motivate everyone to come together and support a good cause.
基金会主席陈耀伦指出，网上活动较难知道参加者的即时反应，但制作时间和成本都较以往少。
There's more flexibility, because like for like our kind of event, the only main part was just connecting with the different performers from around the world and kind of making sure that we get the footage. But like in-person events, like for bigger, large-scale fundraising events like galas or high teas.You really have to like, it takes like maybe like half a year or maybe longer to plan the whole event because you want to make sure all the flow and everything is good. Virtually, it is a little bit more difficult to kind of inspire donors to donate money virtually, but from a cost perspective, it is more cost effective compared to in-person events. For example, we do a Mother's Day high tea. We have to have the venue, we have to have the decor, and then there's also the cost of...There's some other miscellaneous costs associated with the event as well. But when we do it virtually, the only cost that would come up would be the production cost of putting the whole concert together.
而网上活动嘅另外一个好处就系冇地域限制，主办方可以更加容易同其他地方嘅人合作。
We're able to connect with different youth artists from around the world.And most of these youth artists are very talented because they've been on America's Got Talent or The Voice Kids. But I think that one highlight that we had for the August Youth in Motion concert is that we were able to get a greeting from Prime Minister Justin Trudeau. So that was the highlight. Like, because I sent out emails to get some greetings from government officials, not really expecting to have anything come back because I just shot the email. I know these government people are very busy.
Let's check out what's in your at-home gala box. This box has been thoughtfully curated.
Many of the charities have developed in-home gala kits. So when you purchase a ticket to an event, you are able to receive a beautiful meal or a drink or party favors so that it feels like you're part of a gala.
而獅網上的慈善晚宴很多時候都還有拍賣環節， Fred 表示一些宴會會將拍賣品擺到網上，方便進行競投。
We have over 100 unique items and experiences available, and I can see already the bidding is hot, frenzied. So let's have a look now at some of those bids and our leaderboard.
Where I was used to before getting a script and showing up the night of in a ballroom,It is taking a lot more time as you're literally producing a show virtually for people to see. And it is only when you're in that studio, are they able to get an appreciation of lighting, coordinating the lighting, the cameras, the teleprompter with all the other devices that you're using to monitor the auction, social media that happens,on site as well. It is quite a different animal, for sure, being on a virtual, presenting a virtual event.
选择网上活动形式方面，机构可以因应活动对象、互动性等的因素去决定。
It could be on a Zoom platform. It could be more traditional, where it is a digital format, very much like watching a television show or a variety show, and segments are produced.And it's a one-way interaction. To get more of that connectivity, obviously, it's really about asking them, what is the best way that your audience will receive the event? Would they prefer more of an interaction and connection? And if so, Zoom. But obviously, Zoom has its limitations as well. Or is it more of a one-way produced event?But using technology such as Givergy or Slido or other platforms for that audience engagement.
網上活動對於活動策劃同製作團隊嚟講，仍然係個比較新嘅模式。Fred 認為事前溝通同彩排都非常重要。
Because it's not just the charity organizations that are entering the virtual arena for the first time.There's a lot of production companies and AV companies who have never had charities as clients. So they don't really understand what a charity event looks like, let alone how it is produced on a virtual format. I can't say enough about technical dress rehearsal. It's really important because for many of these folks,You know, they're used to being in a ballroom producing an event, but not in a studio. And it is quite different. And just knowing the technical abilities, capabilities, needs. Every time I'm in an event now, there is a script run through where we review the script. And then we do a technical run through.
Tonight, we all virtually have raised $3.76 million!
疫情期間值得慶幸的是善長人翁的熱心未有減退，一些網上活動籌得的善款甚至較往年高。
Arts Umbrella was one. They were so close to not having an event, and then they raised the most ever, $1.1 million. The Inspire Health Gala, it's a fundraiser for cancer patients.Supporting cancer individuals on their cancer journey. They were this close to canceling their event, but they went ahead and they raised over $150,000, their second most they've ever raised in their gala.
在可见的未来，网上活动相信仍然会是主流活动模式，而在疫情结束之后，活动策划或者会变得更有弹性。
And it'll be very interesting to see what that hybrid or blended events will look like in the future.
If it's post-COVID, I definitely think that we would probably still do some sort of virtual events, but kind of transition back intoorganizing in-person events as well.
I hope next year we can do this all again in person. Stick around for a bit and enjoy the sounds of DJ Leanne as we start our after party. Thank you, everyone!
好了，今集的节目时间又差不多了。如果观众对我们的节目有任何意见的话，欢迎以电邮的方式和我们联络。观众也可以上网看回今集的节目内容。多谢收看，下星期再见。